What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Chaotic Battles channel. Today, we've got a 4v4 at Enlow Fork. I'll be playing as Bragg's Corps. MM will be playing as Polk's Corps. Ministop will be playing as the Armies of the Potomac and Shenandoah. And Irish will be playing as Hardy's Corps. As the Union, I don't remember who plays what corps, with the exception of First Corps. First Corps is played by Mclovin. And then I believe VoicefulMoth, or NK, is the 20 and 21st Corps. And then the other two are Wolf. Wolf will be playing either the 5th Corps or the 11th Corps, because I don't think he's playing the 20 and 21st Corps. But yeah, the Union is NK, VoicefulMoth, Wolf, and Mclovin. Mclovin for sure, though, is the first career. Got some more reserves coming out. This is supposed to be a joke game, because the corps we took kind of weren't really serious, you know. Not many people take the first Manassas Corps. I've never had success with them. And I've never really played as Hardy's Corps or Polk's Corps. Actually, this is my first Bragg's Corps game. I didn't really have a high opinion of Bragg's Corps before this. I do now. Dang, those skirmishers went down. So I got, Bragg's Corps is actually pretty good shooters. And not only are they good shooters, they're good melee, and like over half of their units can be bucket ball, and they're huge in number, like 250, 300, and they get bucket ball. So the ground almost doesn't even matter. Looks like Ministop and MM are doing a good job of keeping artillery on them. This does not look like a fun place to be. All the artillery in the game is hitting this one point. I'm guessing Wolf is playing 11th or 5th Corps. Otherwise, Irish would be lined up with him. I'm about to rotate through and take the front line so that I can start putting bucketball into them right away. I'm going to go for some double ranking fire here as well when I get time. But I think I end up switching up because I'm getting flanked right here. That's pretty good damage for uphill. Pulling back from that position. We're really pushing hard. We're at the bottom of this ravine. It's a shit position to be in. We have no choice but to push really hard. Bye. It was my second line of buck and ball going in. These are my bigger units. It's about 1,000 buck and ball. Oh, 950 with some losses taken. Just in that front row. That 14th Brooklyn, though. Oof. So they're falling even further back up the hill. They're having a good time of shooting up. There's a lot of the Iron Brigade right in the front line here. So with my buck and ball really tearing into bits, which it is, really badly, eventually he's going to be forced to make a move. So I pretty much had to deploy everything out and about, just because everything's getting stretched so thin, our lines are getting stretched pretty thin here. But I'm really still kicking the crap out of him in these woods, just because of the buck and ball. charged me. So Mclovin ends up charging me all across my lines. With like everything. And things are getting a little desperate, but we keep moving. I got my general here still, so he's trying to keep everyone in the fight. We really gotta deal with that Iron Brigade unit, and then we got another one coming in right now. So we're still in a tough fight. We still have, we're fighting all the Iron Brigade pretty much still. Their numbers are getting low though. Still an intense shooting battle in these woods. Some of his men ashore in the unit. Or not Mini, MM. Mini's right here. Now we have to push him here, while still continuing to push the rest of this way. So we're still pushing pretty tough ground here. Hardy's is really getting in here. They gotta pull back. They're routing across the board here. They're gonna have to find new ground. Mini stops keeping it together for now. They'll have to shift right though, along with MM. Taking the guns. Oh yeah, I forgot I rolled up some of his Willich. Irish is doing a good job performing a fighting retreat here. Trying to buy any time he can. They still have halfway decent ground, but you know, they're outnumbered a lot on this side. Will be hard to bring down. This is one of the boldest moves I've ever done. So let's check out how many infantry there are here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 units and 2 of mine. Definitely one of my most glorious moments. And it's too Willich. Here we go, here we go. It's gonna be close. One in both spots. I'm still going, right? Yes, big artillery hit. Great job, man. Another one. They pull one out. But I'm still in the fight. I run my general up. I put a inspire on him and keep him in the game. Win that, and they're gonna charge to this one. It is still going. So with just those two units, I've broken their whole left flank now. It was a brilliant. It was a brilliant charge. These nice Mississippians are tough. Oh, it's so close right here. It's desperate. So he won, now he's going for the artillery. My general's trying to keep him in play over here. Closer I got some vicious canister and there was no shot. I mean, I routed them, but I also got routed. But that's okay. They did a lot of damage. They single-handedly, those two units destroyed their whole left flank. I don't see it effectively coming back again. We've got great artillery fire coming in. battle is close range. Mclovin disconnected. Also, before the battle started recording, we had an artillery battle between me and Mclovin. His artillery was... Well, me, Mclovin, and MM. He had his artillery up here. I'm sorry, he had his artillery over here. And we had ours in the woods over here. Oh, the fight is desperate. At least Mini has some guns here you can really counter with. I'm not Mini, MM. I gotta stop calling him Mini. Sorry, MM. Bringing two units up there, the 16th and 18th Louisiana, drive off the rest of 11th Corps over here. Just one unit, one or two. But they're back in the field now here, giving MM a hard time. So I'm moving some men over here to deal with it. While we're also being pressed by 11th Corps here, right down the center. It's getting pretty desperate though, because 5th Corps is pushing everything up and the flank is just open in the air. There's really nothing out here. I mean, MM has some recovered men now, but anything that's coming to that force is coming out unchecked. So it'd be me putting a lot of bucking ball on them if I can. Seems to be working so far. Just go right down the line. See what MM does here. See if he puts a canister on him or not. Oh yeah, they're going down.
there. Finish coming up.
Let's see how it goes.
Yes, sir.
Probably wasn't the right move to back up even further. Not when I'm trying to engage you. I get to come in and sweep on them. That should be close to it. I see a couple more units on the screen. Alright guys, I'm gonna fast forward to the next one. Let's take a look at some of the battlefield.
Those woods are full of bodies.
Man, oh man. Alright guys, thank you for watching.